Welcome you back for the sessions or discussions on the polymer MEMS and microfluids and case studies. Now, the first what we are discussing is with respect to the polymer MEMS and or microfluids. Here in this, what we are discussing is the different types of polymers that especially what we are using in the field of MEMS and also the applications. The motivations of the microfluids and also the biological concepts, design fabrication of the selective components with respect to the channels and walls. The next part is with respect to the case studies. Here in this case studies, we are discussing with respect to the MEMS, magnetic actuators, BP sensors, microphones, acceleration sensors, and as well as the gyro. Now here, after discussing with respect to the MEMS product development, performances, accuracies, repeatability, reliability, managing costs and marketing uncertainty, and also the investment and competition that we are discussing in the fifth module. Now, the introduction with respect to the polymer. Now, the polymer are a large, what we can say, unusually chain-like molecules that are built from a small molecules. In a simpler way, if you want to say that the polymers, as the names it suggested, poly and as well as mers, if monomers are put together forming a chain, this chain is nothing but a polymer. The long chain of the polymer composed of a structure which is called as a mers, united together to form a chain. Now the bulk polymers are made of a many polymer chains. Even these polymer chains, either it may be in these chains, it may be in the form of a three basic classes. The first one is nothing but a fibers, or it may be a plastics, and as well as the elastomers. Now the polymers are also, it can be classified as the thermoset and also thermoplast polymers. The large number of different types of polymeric materials common under the plastic classifications is either it may be a polyethylene or polypropylene or the fluorocarbon, epoxies, and so on. The many of the plastic materials which comes under the category of the acrylics, or it may be the acrylides, or it may be a leucides, or it may be the plexiglass. See, these are what we can say, the many plastic materials which are manufactured by a different vendors by a different names. The vendors are many which are incorporated by using a additive structures into a polymers and adjusted to the, what we can say, the physical, chemical, or it may be the electrical, thermal, and even the mechanical characteristics and the change in their appearance. Now, as you know that the polymers are three types. The properties of the polymers are also varying, that depending upon the, what we can say, either it may be the elastomers, or it may be plastics, or it may be the fibers. Now, the polymers are classified based on the, what we can say, the temperature. The first one is nothing but a thermoplast or plast polymers. The another one is nothing but a thermoset polymers. Now, the thermoplastic polymers, which is also called as a thermoplast polymers, can be melted and reshaped repeatedly, whereas a thermosetting polymers, which is called as a thermoset polymers, these, the melting and as well as reusability is not at all possible. The mechanical properties of the polymers differs from those with respect to the metals and as well as the semiconductors in a several major aspects. Even we know that the polymer materials are also having a major application in the industrial and even in the medical and even in the chemical, that are all depends upon what we can say, the Young's modulus. The maximum tensile strength of the polymers are one order of 100 megapascals, and which is lower than that of the metals and also the semiconductor materials. The third one is many polymers exhibits a viscoelastic behaviors. These, when the force is applied to it, what we can say, instantaneous elastic deformation may occur. As a result of the, what we can say, the polymeric material is susceptible to time dependent and also the deformation under a constantly maintained stresses. The mechanical properties, like either it may be a temperature, or it may be molecular weight, or even even what we can say, the additives what it has been added are influences the characteristics of the mechanical properties. The mechanical properties of a certain polymer can be changed dramatically over a narrow temperature range. The next what we are discussing is with respect to the polymer in MEMS. See, the as you know that if we start using with respect to the silicon and also the silicon oxide as one of the MEMS material, and if we start using it, the cost parameters is also increasing it, and also the fabrication method and also the involvement with respect to the technology is also laborious. The micro machining technology for the MEMS is derived from the integrated circuits fabrication. The most of the circuits or it may be the electronic devices are fabricated by using the polymers only. The natural silicon has been a predominant material of choice. In the recent years, the polymers are also used as a MEMS material. There are a number of unique what we can say the merits associated with respect to the polymeric materials. The first is nothing but the cost. The cost of the material is lower when compared to a single crystalline silicon. The second one is the many polymer materials allows a unique with respect to the fabrication, or it may be the style, or it may be a packaging technique, and also the micro modeling and molding, and also what we can say the different technologies which are adapting to get the mold and also the shapes. The instead of processing on one wafer at a time, the polymer substrates can be potentially be processed with a high throughput, what we can say the roll to roll fashion. Now the third one is nothing but the polymer of a unique electrical, physical and also the chemical properties. As you know that these polymer materials are stable to the electrical, physical and also the chemical properties, it can be used in the case of the MEMS. The another which is a important property, which is nothing but the mechanical shock tolerances and also biocompatibility and also biodegradability is also concerned with respect to these type of materials. Now with respect to the polymer material in MEMS, there is a very huge list, but here what we are discussing is with respect to only the 7 materials. The different materials what we are discussing is with respect to the polyamides and also SU8, the liquid crystal polymer, the polydimethyl siloxylene and polymethyl and methacrylate, which is nothing but PMMA, and pyrrolidine, and which is also called as polyperoxylene, and polytetrafluoroethylene, which is in a simpler way it is called as the Teflon. These materials we are discussing and which are having a major application in the MEMS technology. Now the first what we are discussing is nothing but the polyamides. Now the polyamides is nothing but represents a family of the polymer which is exhibiting a outstanding mechanical, chemical and even the thermal properties. The wide use of the microelectronic industries is with respect to the insulating material, and what we can say a non-conducting material is the polyamides. The polyamides are formed from a what we can say the dehydrocrystallization of the polymeric precursor in a cyclic polymer by incorporating aromatic group. These aromatic groups are chosen which affects the properties of the final polyamides. Now the polyamides materials are having a favorable characteristics in the role of the what we can say the chemical stability, the thermal stability around 400 degree centigrade, and even superior dielectric property, the mechanical robustness and durability, and also the low cost material and the processing equipments also low cost with respect to the fabrication technology also. Now this is what we can say a chemical composition of a material which comes under the polyamide. Now the next topic what we are discussing is with respect to SU8. The SU8 is a negative toned near UV photo resistant, first invented by means of an IBM, that too especially in 1980s. The photoresist consists of epon resin and SU8. The epon resin is dissolved in an organic solvent with a quantity of the solvent determining the viscosity and the range of achievable thickness. Now here the polyimide chemistry. Now here in this case, the what we can say, the chemical equation, or it may be the SU8 lithography with respect to the considerably a lower than that of the other techniques, and also the realizing the high aspect ratio with respect to the microstructure and also LIGA process. Now the next part what we are discussing is with respect to the liquid crystal polymer. Liquid crystal polymer is a polymer which comes under the category of the thermoplast with a unique structural and also the physical properties. These characteristics differentiate the LCP from that of the thermoplastic polymer, whose molecule chain are randomly oriented in a solid state. Now, as you know that the one of the earliest and as well as LCP films used in the case of the MEMS is nothing but the Vector A950 aromatic liquid crystal polymer. The reported melting temperature of this is around 280 degree centigrade. The specific gravity is ranging from 1.37 to 1.42. The compatibility of the LCP with a commonly used chemical and as well as the micro machining is first investigated in. Now, the expensive test has been shown that LCP, or it may be the liquid crystal polymer was not attacked and or dissolved by at least following chemical common and as well as the micro fabrication. The organic solvents includes acetone and alcohol, even the metal etchants like either it may be the aluminium or it may be Au is nothing but a gold, and as well as even the krypton. The oxide etchants is also a very easily it can be done. Then the stability of the developer is also another major aspect, and which is very common in the case of the LCP, that too especially in the case of the Kapton. Now it is useful to compare the LCP with the Kapton. Another polymer sheet is that has been used in the case of the MEMS in the recent years. For example, whereas the Kapton is often bonded with a intermediate adhesive layers, the LCP films can be bonded other surface directly by the laminations. The commercial LCPs materials is supplied in the form of the sheets only. The thickness of the LCP films could be varying from several microns to even millimeters, depending upon the type of the applications. Some can be provided with a copper cladded layer, or it indirectly what we can say a copper coated layer on the LCPs, and one or on the both the sides. The optional of the copper cladding layer is normally a thick one. The copper layer is laminated by the vacuum press at a temperature is around the melting point of the LCPs.